Hi everyone, this is Maggie from the Glendale Community College English Department, and I'm here to give you a quick tutorial on using Perusall as a student. I'm going to take you through four important things to know about using Perusall. First, how to get to your Perusall assignment. Second, how to use Perusall to annotate by yourself. Third, how to use Perusall to annotate collaboratively. And fourth, how to download or print available materials. The first thing you should know about using Perusall is how to get to your assignment. When you use Perusall, there are several ways to get to a Perusall assignment. However, getting to the Perusall assignment in the correct way is important for allowing Perusall to communicate your grade to Canvas. So, you may see that you have a Perusall link in this navigation bar. However, when you are going to start working on an assignment, instead of using that Perusall link, you will want to go to the assignment itself. As you can see here, I have a final project Perusall assignment. In the text box, I have the information about what I should be reading or highlighting and annotating for in this assignment. This will be given to you by the professor, who is telling you what you should be looking for. When you click on this Load Final Project Perusall Assignment in a new window, this link, whatever that assignment is called, will open in a new window for you. I have already opened it here so that we can see it in a student view. When you get to the Perusall screen, you will see all the assignments for your course on the left toolbar. You will also see the assignment that you clicked on in the right side. If you have not yet opened it, it will say that to you in this blue, and all you have to do to click to open it is work on the assignment. When you do so, the first time you do so, you will get this tour, which will tell you that the yellow highlights are other students' comments, the blue highlights are instructor comments, and it gives you some other tips for navigating. I'm going to end the tour because I'm going to do my own tips here, but I encourage you to look through that tour the first time around. Now, when you get to the Perusall assignment, the assignment that you're professor has given you will pop up here. To get rid of that, you can close that out. And now we're in our Perusall assignment. So now, step two is reading and annotating by yourself. This is something you might want to do the first time you read any text. Really look at it and understand it on your own before you start reading other people's comments. To do so, you can select no comments from the selection in the top right side of the toolbar. You can also select all of your comments or other people's comments, comments where you were mentioned, instructor comments only, questions only, etc. But for now, and the first time you read any assignment, I encourage you to try no comments at first. Now you have the opportunity to read a clean text without seeing anyone else's comments on that text. You can also take notes for yourself. These notes will not be shared with your instructor or with other students. Therefore, these notes are also not graded. So if you're being graded for your Perusall assignments, these notes will not count towards your grade. However, they might be useful to you if you're going to use this text to write essays, or if you're going to use this text to study in the future. To create a new note, you simply press New, and then you can highlight. Let's say I want to highlight this sentence. That will pop up then into my note-taking area, as you see, and I can write my own notes as well. I can take a long page of notes about the whole text, or I can take multiple notes about the text. And I can use the open to toggle between the notes that I have written on the text. All right, so once you've read your assignment on Perusall, the next step is to use Perusall collaboratively. And this is really the important part because this is what most of your professors want you to be doing in order to get Perusall grades. So I have now turned all comments on so I can see everyone else's comments on this text. And I can close the notes or I can open all conversations. All conversations will show me every other highlight or annotation that another student has made. At this point, I can click on that and see exactly what the student said. If you hover over the icon, you will see the person's name, and you can see what they said about the text when they highlight it. You can keep going back to all conversations and see different things that they may have said. Now, to interact and collaborate with your classmates, there are three things that you can do. First, you can write your own comment. So this is another place where you can, as you're reading, highlight and say something about that. Now, it doesn't save your highlight unless you have written a comment to go with that. So I might write, this is about today's students. Actually, I'm going to put, this is about students in 2001. That comment is now available for my instructor and for other students to see. However, if someone has already highlighted something, let's say I'm down here, and I was going to highlight this, but I see it's already been highlighted. If this person has said the same thing I was going to say, or if something that they said helped my understanding, a way to interact with that text is to upvote it by simply clicking the check mark. Or if you can answer the question, you can click to answer a question. You can also ask a question yourself. As you can see, because I wrote a question or a misunderstanding, this pops up automatically as a question for me. And this will help others know that this is a question that I have and they can answer it for me. Another thing that you can do to collaborate with your classmates is to communicate directly to them. So if, for example, I wanted to speak directly to Jonathan's point here, I could type at, and it would pull him up, Jonathan. At Jonathan, I don't know if this is exactly what he is saying. And now I have a comment directly to Jonathan. At some point, Jonathan will be able to see that when he goes into his comments. He can see that he was mentioned at certain places, and he could respond to me, and we can have a conversation about the text itself. The final thing that I think is very important for you to know how to do is to download and print your texts. This may not be available for every text. It is based on copyright. However, if it is available for your text, you will see the print button here in the top middle toolbar, or you will see the download button here in the right side of the top toolbar. Those are the two things that you need to be able to print and to download the text that the professor has posted for you on Perusall. Thank you so much for watching and happy Perusalling!